Chris Bowen is sure onto something when he says that Labor needs to reconnect with the suburbs. Then he goes on to show he's more interested in middle Australia's votes than its values, than our values. Bowen, Labor's new climate shadow, has just released a book. It's called On Charlatans. With the usual lefty rhetoric against everyone from Donald Trump to Pauline Hanson, is cover for some half-sensible observations and for the Labor Party itself. Now, of course, Bowen's right, that Labor has lost touch with the working people that once were its base. These days, at least federally, Labor hardly holds a seat outside the capital cities and is under pressure from the coalition in aspirational suburbs and, of course, from the Greens in the inner cities. But typically, Bowen wants to have it both ways. He wants to win back tradies by focusing more on jobs and services, and he wants to keep the Green left by maintaining the emissions obsession that will likely cost those very jobs he says he cares about. If Bowen really were the answer to Labor's problem, he wouldn't have begun his stint as the new climate shadow, as he has, by stressing no change to the very same policies that Labor wouldn't cost and couldn't explain at the last federal election. Now, that's because Chris Bowen, to be fair to him, can see Labor's problem, but not its real cause. He claims that it was the global financial crisis of globalisation that's discombobulated Labor's base, yet he seems to ignore the cultural Marxism, which is now rampant inside the Labor Party. It's like the gender obsessions of Victorian Labor, which means that teenagers have to seek parental permission to get a tattoo, but not a sex change operation, that won't allow them to smoke a cigarette or buy a bottle of wine, but will allow them to inject a cocktail of hormones to deliver a result that will change their life forever. It's the apparent disdain for our history and sheer ignorance of it that drives left-wing councils to cancel Australia Day. It's the politically correct education system that thinks correct spelling, grammar and rote learning, things like the Times table, somehow interferes with children's creativity. It's taking the UN more seriously than our own country and its best interests. Of course, the climate cult is just the most obvious example when Australians vote for something very, very different than what we're told out of the UN, but they're ignored by elites who think they know better. Labor's deeper problem is that its MPs like Bowen might represent the western suburbs, but they're hardly of the western suburbs. They might have been born there, but then, of course, it was university, young Labor activism, working for the unions or MPs, and finally life inside the Canberra bubble where paying the mortgage, managing a commute and holding on to a job is like a foreign country to them. Or it's MPs like Shadow Attorney General Mark Dreyfus, who lives a long way away from his electorate in very leafy suburbs of Melbourne's Kooyong area, rather than the outer suburbs of Isaacs amongst the people he says he's proud to represent. But I don't want to let the Liberals off the hook here either. People like Labor's Chris Bowen are almost interchangeable with people like Liberals' Matt Keane, the New South Wales Energy Minister, who likewise entered Parliament while still in short pants, sees everything in terms of this political manoeuvre and that political manoeuvre, and who'd gladly be on a unity ticket with Labor on climate change, regardless of what it does to secure well-paid jobs in manufacturing and mining, which Liberals say they support. Liberals like Matt Keane love to quote Sir Robert Menzies' observation, and it is that we took the name Liberal because we were determined to be a progressive party. But then Keane likes to ignore his later lament, and I quote, this is from Menzies, Liberals with a small L, that's to say Liberals who believe in nothing but will believe in anything if they think it's worth a few votes. The whole thing is tragic. So said the Liberal Party founder, who was also reported to have voted DLP in his later years over Liberals who he believed in little. Now, whether you want to call them Menzies' forgotten people or Howard's battlers or Morrison's quiet Australians, Labor has lost them. And it'll never get them back while the likes of Bowen hold sway. But the Liberals can't take them for granted either, especially while they're toying with joining Labor on net zero emissions and the havoc that will wreak on farming, mining, manufacturing industries that we need to sustain Australia's prosperity. And I've got to say here to Canberra, wake up to where we are in the world today, in 2021. The fact that none of you can get a phone call return out of Beijing, the reality that we're wasting billions in substandard submarine builds at a time of growing regional vulnerability with China decimating our two-way trade, then you want to sell me on this plan to impoverish us all to meet a UN climate goal that our competitors will never, ever match, making our power more expensive and unreliable, our jobs scarcer, our resource exports less, and our balance sheet more precarious. You're trying to sell me that? I tell you what, Canberra, in the end, that's what you're asking us to sign up to. That's the choice you're putting on the table. And all you need to do is to look at what's happening in the world today. Look at our region. Look at abroad into Europe and North America. Look at the competitiveness now of India and the might of China. Without a doubt, this is the moment in history to make Australia stronger, more secure, more prepared, more able to build, grow and manufacture what we need here, rather than make us more vulnerable. And vulnerable is where we're headed if we decide that the climate czars in Geneva deserve more of a say in our country's future than ordinary Australians.